Three big banks have halted foreclosures in Wisconsin and 22 other states. As 12 News' Terry Sater found out earlier tonight, attorney generals want an investigation to figure out if people were kicked out of their homes illegally.
Well, the foreclosure process hasn't stopped. It's been ballooning.
Tony Wagner's response to hearing several national banks have now temporarily stopped foreclosures after admitting papers were often signed without proper review of documents that kick families out of homes.
They are shuffling paperwork faster than we can imagine, from banks to servicers to mortgage companies to it's not my problem.
Wagner serves with the Milwaukee branch of Common Ground, an organization trying to lobby banks to take responsibility for the blight of foreclosed, empty, and rundown homes in Milwaukee.
6,400 people in the city of Milwaukee are facing foreclosure.
Bethany Sanchez is with the local Fair Lending Program and isn't surprised some banks are finding mistakes in their foreclosure filings.
They were being sloppy. They were making money hand over fist, and they loved it, which, you know, is human nature, but they got sloppy about their record keeping, and now it's coming home to roost.
And now there's even more confusion in a confusing process. For example, GMAC Mortgage issued a statement reading, quote, "Contrary to recent press reports, GMAC Mortgage is not suspending foreclosures in any state. The company has temporarily suspended evictions and post-foreclosure closings in the 23 states while we conduct a review." Sanchez would like to see the banks dig a little deeper into their paperwork.
For those people that got bad loans and that shouldn't have had those high-priced loans in the first place, that they help them out.
Sanchez says she's meeting with Federal Reserve Chairman Ben Bernanke next week, but says she doesn't have much hope that banks will be pressured to change.